Sadly, we've seen the last of Derek Fisher in a Lakers uniform and the last of him actually playing in the NBA. But that just makes looking back on some of his greatest moments in Lakers history all the more nostalgic. Hopefully you get as much enjoyment out of this as I do. For LakersNation.com, I'm Serena Winters. Now, we could spend hours taking a look back at Fisher's clutch shots, but instead we take a look back at Fisher's top five moments in Lakers history. Those moments where, as a Lakers fan, you just smile when thinking about D-Fish. At number five, we go back to game two of the 2001 NBA Finals. The Lakers were down one game to the Philadelphia 76ers. And before you do a double take, yes, you are about to see Derek Fisher with a full head of hair. And trust me, this was some hard footage to come by. Out of a timeout, Fisher with the steal charging to the basket for a breakaway dunk over Sixer star Allen Iverson, with his offhand extending that Lakers lead. Who knew Fish had that in him? The Lakers went on to win game two. At number four, our most memorable Fisher moments wouldn't be complete without the famous D-Fish elbow to Luis Scola's chest. It was another game two, this time of the 2009 Western Conference Semifinals, a heated series, and things got testy from the get-go. After a physical first three quarters, Fisher decided it was time for him to send a message. Scola was the unfortunate recipient. Fisher going straight up Bruce Lee with that elbow, knocking the 240-pound, 6'9" power forward straight to the ground. Fisher did get an ejection and a flagrant two, but no one called Derek soft after that one. And at number three, a year later, the 2010 NBA Finals, the series was tied up at one apiece. TD Garden was up on its feet as the Celtics had pulled within 1 point, just 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. Well, Fisher came in replacing a struggling Pau Gasol and went to work, knocking down a beautiful 12-foot jumper and going on to make four consecutive shots, giving the Lakers a 78-73 lead. But Fisher wasn't done. With 49 seconds remaining, Fisher laid in his fifth basket right before sprawling to the floor after a hard foul. Oh, and he converted that three-point play too, one of his finest postseason performances of his career. At number two, it was another clutch NBA Finals performance by D-Fish. 2009 Game 4 against Orlando Magic, the Lakers were down by three with 10.8 seconds left in regulation, and Derek pulls up for a three in transition to send the game into overtime. Then, to seal the deal, with 31.3 seconds left in OT, Fish drills another dagger, and the Lakers beat the Orlando Magic 99-91, taking a 3-1 series lead over Orlando. And after the game, Fisher said that moment ranks right up there at the top, even greater than this moment that we have at our number one. May 13th, 2004, the Lakers and Spurs were knotted up at 2-2, going into Game 5 of the Western Conference Semifinals. Tim Duncan had just buried a 17-foot leaning jumper while falling to his left that had him asking his bench if a shot went in. It did. The Spurs were up by one, and all that was left was three timeouts, a full by the Lakers, a 20 by the Spurs, and a 20 by the Lakers. Oh, and 4/10 of a second on the clock. Gary Payton was looking to inbound to Kobe, but he was being heavily pressured by Devin Brown and Robert Horry, and there was no getting it to Shaq on the block. Instead, it was time for D-Fish to make history, one of the most clutch playoff shots of all time. With just enough time to catch and shoot, Payton gets it into a cutting Fisher, who nails an off-balance 16-foot buzzer beater over Manu Ginobili, forever known as the Point Four. All right, guys, well, that concludes our top five Derek Fisher moments in Lakers history. Where were you during your favorite Derek Fisher moment? I can still remember watching Fish's Point Four on my old school RCA box TV, standing about an inch and a half from the screen. So let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to our Lakers Nation YouTube channel.